Hello everyone, this is just one more quick video. I was talking to some people and they were kind of confused on the last part of the owls, kind of the bombardment and the fission, those two sections. I think everyone, the radioactivity and the other one you just needed to read. So I think everyone's got that. If not, I gladly will make another video. But so I thought I would just go over bombardment and fission. So nuclear bombardment, let's just review that first. Okay, so nuclear bombardment is when they take an atom and they quote unquote chuck, I'm going to say, they throw a nucleus or an alpha particle at the atom to they bombard it and energy is produced. So when particles are thrown at an atom to produce energy, or it can cause fissions. So nuclear fissions are when atoms split in half. So they become two separate atoms. Now you have one large atom, now you have two smaller, about equally sized new atoms. So I just grabbed these examples off of my owls. Obviously, you know, they generate different questions for everyone, but should probably be something similar to yours. So here's one. 235 uranium plus a neutron. And now we know it's bombardment because this neutron is on the reactant side. So we're putting this neutron with this uranium, and then we are getting a blank. And then we're not going to be able to see it all because my screen is so small. 54. What is 54? Sorry. Xe plus 3 neutrons. Okay, so if I zoom out, that's the equation we're given, and you have to fill in this blank. Now, remember for nuclear equations, you need to get the mass numbers and the atomic numbers on both sides equal. So on this side, we have a mass number of 2. Oh, now we're writing a sparkly pen. Okay, 236. It's kind of hard to see. Oh goodness, this is going great. This is why you don't record videos at 8:39. Okay, 236. We need an atomic number of 92. Well, on this side, we already have, so neutron is always one, but we have three neutrons. So we have to add those up. So we have a mass number of now 3 here, plus 139, which is 142. And then we have atomic number of 54. So what we need to do is we need to take 236 minus 142, which gives us 94. Then 92 minus 54 gives us 38, and that gives us SR. And so that's the answer to what needs to go in that blank. Because you don't need to balance out the elements, you just need to balance out the masses and the atomic numbers. So, and then you just add them all up together. And so each side should equal the other one. So now the next two questions are about what type of reaction this is. So we can just do this on this one. So since we have this neutron on the reactant side, it's going to be a bombardment reaction because we're bombarding this uranium, the neutron. It's also going to be a fission because we have created two separate atoms with similar-ish masses. And so these are two new atoms, and then this is also a possible chain reaction because we have three neutrons left also, and those could split off and become new things. So that's how you tell if bombardment, you have a particle here on the reactant side, unless you're doing electron capture, but either from the examples I've seen, it's either going to be a neutron or an alpha. And then if you have two separate elements, atoms, on your product side, that's fission. You broke your starting one apart. And then if you have, say, a three neutrons, if you have neutrons, more than one, that could start a chain reaction. So there's another one where you have stable nitrogen, or I believe that's stable. Helium, this is also known as alpha. And then you have oxygen and a hydrogen. Okay, so now this is just bombardment. There is definitely an R in there somewhere. Okay, this is just bombardment because it's not alpha decay. Because if it's alpha decay, it would be over here. But it's not over here. It's on the reactant side, not the product side. So it's just bombardment. We haven't split into two new atoms. I mean, technically, we do have this atom, but they're not equal. You know, 11 in 1. Oh, that's actually 17. See, that's even nowhere near as close. 17 in 1. So it's not fission because they won't break apart. There's no electrons, so it's not beta or anything. So it is just bombardment. Okay, so there were some problems with helium, alpha bombardment, so you had blank, and then 4-2 helium, which leads, this is just the equation from before, but how did we get that? So, like the one we did earlier, we need the same mass and the same atomic number, so 18, 9, and we already have 4, 2, so 14, 7. So, I hope that's pretty straightforward. So that's just the bombardment and the fission equations. And so just like every other nuclear equation, you need mass and atomic numbers equal on both sides. And that is how, for nuclear equations only, that is what we're aiming for. So I hope that helps, and I know the owls already do, so this won't help now. But for the test, if this comes up, know what's going on. Thanks so much, everyone.